everyone. Today is Maria's Monday Madness video tutorials, and today's tutorial will be on coloring with Stampin' Up! Markers and mixing Stampin' Up! Pastels or pastels in general. Okay, what you'll be needing are Stampin' Up! Markers, an aquapainter brush, Stampin' Up! Pastels, or any brand of pastels, Q-tips, watercolor paper, 90 pound weight is sufficient. And I'll also show you how to use the color spritzer tool by Stampin' Up. You'll also need stamps, obviously. Okay. First of all, using a water resistant ink. In this case, I use VersaFine. Well, before I begin coloring, I wanted to explain a little bit about mixing color mediums. There's no rule to say that you can't mix color mediums, like markers with pastel, Copic markers with watercoloring, acrylic with reinkers, whatever, So, with this tutorial, I wanted to show how you can mix pastels with markers and watercoloring with these mediums. Sometimes you don't have every color of every marker that Stampin' Up! Carries, or all the pastels that Stampin' Up! Has. So by mixing the mediums, you expand your the variety of colors that you can use on your images. Okay. What I'll do first is on the brush side of the marker, outline the image in certain parts of it. Okay. Also, I'm going to add a bit of, what was this? More mustard, a little bit on parts of it. So just to give it shades of color, rather than having it flat looking, I like to mix the colors a little bit. And now you take your aqua painter brush and get it all wet and start coloring in the image. Okay, to add a little bit more orange, I just put a bit of the marker on a something plastic. Okay, and pick up some color. Instead of a darker color, I used Really Rust. Okay, and just sort of swirl it around, blending the colors in. Okay, continue the process of blending the colors. Make sure it's blended. Otherwise, you'll leave watermarks. And just continue picking up some color. Okay, so now you're thinking, okay, I don't have the more mustard marker. And you want it to have that color, but you do have it in pastel. So what you can do is take your pastel, and before doing this, make sure your watercolor paper is dry, and what I did is blow dry it to speed up the process. And I rubbed with a Q-tip more mustard to the center. I actually have more mustard marker, but just pretend I don't. I rub a little bit of the more mustard pastel because I don't pretend I don't have the marker. So, and taking my Real Rust again, sort of mixing in the color a little bit. Go over it with your aqua painter and blend the colors in. And this gives you a really nice shade of orange and yellows where your image don't look, you know, flat. Now, you want to color out the edge or the outside or the white part of your image so it doesn't look like it's floating. So what I do, I start off again with some orange around the outer edge of the image. So it's like a two-step, three-step kind of thing. What I do is add a little bit of ink. And instead of pulling it inside, now you pull outside, out, and color the white parts of your watercolor paper. Okay, so you pull it outwards to color your background. Okay, the next step, we'll use the Stampin' Up! Color Spritzer tool. So on the brush side, you'd stick it in and to the tip, allow some tip over the hole there. I don't know if you can see this. Anyway, test it out. And this adds like speckles. Okay, if you be sure your cardstock or your watercolor paper is already dry before you do this. Alright, so what I'm going to do right now is finish up the card, and I just wanted to let you know, in the video you can't really see the colors and the shading and the different highlights, but in person it's really vibrant, and there's a lot of mix of colors in here. So when you have a chance, try it out and see if you like this technique. Okay, so I'll be back. Okay, everyone, this is my finished card. All I did was added designer paper in the background, cut out some of the images and mounted them with dimensionals, and added some ribbon, and that's basically it. Well, thank you for viewing my tutorial, and I hope to see you again. All right, bye-bye.